Hello, with this short presentation I would like to present you a new version of Tracardi. It's version 0.7.3 and we have implemented three main changes. The first one is the change in graphical user interface. So now Tracardi is much easier to use. You can very quickly find the data you want. The second change is called live segmentation. Live segmentation is a way Tracardi segments the profiles. Right now it can be live and it can be done by a workflow, because we believe that simple segmentation as a rule or logic is not enough. You have to connect to some other systems, just fetch data and be sure that the segment is created the way you want. And the segmentation also must consider how the time passes and what happens with the profile. So for example, if somebody is not visiting your page, the profile should be moved to the different segment. And the third change is a remodeling of event validation and reshaping. This is how you can handle different portions of data. So for example, if the data that comes to the system is big and you want just a portion of it, you can reshape it and have only the data you need. Also, you can validate the event and see that all the data that there should be is actually in that payload. Okay, so let's go and see how it works. Before I continue, I would like you to consider starting our GitHub page and subscribing to this channel. This is the simplest and the best way to support our project. When you log into the system, you will see new graphical user interface. The main changes are in the data section. Now you can see that the most important data is on the list, and you can very quickly go to the data that is connected with an event, for example, a session. And with that session, you can see how the session went and what kind of events there were in the session. And you can also go to the profile and see who was involved in that session. I've made a separate video on this and I will not be explaining every detail of the change in the graphical user interface, but this is one of the main changes. The second new feature is a segmentation engine. The segmentation engine is built this way that it works live. It means it's triggered from time to time. Actually, there is some interval when it triggers, and it looks for the segmentation workflow in which we define how you would like to segment profiles. For example, this one reads a profile, checks if there is some data, for example, if there is an insert time. It reads the last profile visit, then it checks if the last profile visit was within 48 hours, and if it was, it moves it to the segment active, and if it didn't, it moves it to the segment stale. Segmentations are connected via this tab. So let's go and see this one. It has a name, segment active users, and we use a segment user workflow, and we have enabled this segmentation. Okay, and now you can just give it a try. And I will try to test a page view on my web page. Okay. So let's wait a moment. We have our page view and we go to profile and we see that there is no segment because this is a new profile. If you wait a second, the segmentation process will kick off and we'll go through the profiles and we'll find if this profile should be an active profile or a stale profile. Segmentation does not work instantly. When you install a system and the segmentation actually is a commercial feature, you will decide how frequently the segmentation should run. It should not run all the time. Most of the companies do it that they run it once a day, because this is not so important to move a segment just instantly. And I will go and I will trigger segmentation, so we can see how it works. Okay, and now we have an active segment. define hit.profile. So it means that the segmentation kicked off and just segmented this this profile. Segmentation may have different rules. It can move profiles depending on time. It can move profiles depending on the paths the profile made in our page. For example, now visited a page with the product, visited the page that he wanted to, for example, buy something, but then he resigned. And then you say, okay, this profile should be in a different segment. And this all happens automatically. And the last feature is within event management. We have three new tabs. One is event metadata, where we described all the events. When you have a lot of events, then you would like to have human readable description of an event, because sometimes there are just codes, and here you can do it. Then you have event validation, where you defined what event. For example, we have a Tasmora event. This is Internet of Things event, and we can define what kind of data should this event have, what kind of payload. And we have embedded documentation, so you can see and read how to validate event with a JSON schema. This is a short description. And the last thing is event reshaping. When you have a lot of events that come from different systems, the data they send may be huge and you don't want all that data in your system. So for example, we have a GitHub connected to Tracardi, so we want to know when somebody writes an issue, and GitHub sends a lot of data, the information about the repository and the sender, the issue, the comments, and there's a lot of data. But I want only to have issue and sender, and just want it this way, and want under the key issue copied only the data from the issue, actually the title of the issue. And under the key of sender, I want to have everything about the sender. Again, here you have information about how to write it, and you can see that the documentation is embedded in the system, so it's easier for you to understand how to write this code. Actually, this is it. Of course, we've made a lot of different changes. We've prepared a lot of new plugins, and I'm not discussing the new plugins, because with every version we have just a lot new plugins. Some plugins are just hidden, and you have to go to resources and extensions just to find them. I'm not discussing it anymore. But if you are interested what have changed on our GitHub page, there is a file called changes, and there is like a list of the main changes in the system. If you have questions, you can always use this little widget here. Just ask us a question. It will go to our community and we'll try to answer all your questions. This is it. That concludes my presentation. Don't forget to start our project on GitHub. It always gives us more energy to continue with this project.